What's up, guys? Middle Age Gamer here, and we're playing Transport Fever yet again. This is going to be the second mission of the America campaign. I'm going to show you a no-nonsense walkthrough on how to beat the industrialization mission right here, and you can read through this. I got the voiceover turned off because it gets annoying after a while. We'll go over the medals here in a little bit. Let's go ahead and start the mission real quick and get into it, though. This mission will probably take close to about an hour or so. And I definitely recommend that you play the mission at least once or twice before you watch this video, because there will be some, I don't know, I wouldn't really call it secrets, but there's ways to do things. And I'll probably set up actual lines before the mission pops up, so I make sure to get all the gold medals. So I've already played this mission two or three times. I think I got a really, really good system down for you guys that makes it really easy to get all five of the medals. First and foremost, go to Overview, hit Start Mission, and basically what it says is we have to board or disembark passengers in Monroeville, which is over here, and we have to connect it to Pittsburgh Central. So the best way to do that is, of course, go into the train icon right there. We're going to go ahead and do an inline station, and we want it to be 240 meters. You're going to have to basically delete one building, or one building will be removed by placing the station. Not a big deal. Doesn't cost a whole lot of money to do that. Place that right there. In Monroeville, we're going to do basically the same thing, an end station, because we're not going to be going to any other cities during this particular mission. And you can actually place it without deleting any buildings right here in the corner. More importantly, there's a couple options I've tried before, and one was going directly through the mountain building a tunnel. It's really, really expensive. You can probably spend $1 million+ just going this little section right here. So we're going to work around the contour lines by this road to build this rail as cheaply as possible. And of course, as safe as possible for our guys. When building the tracks, just try to do it in smaller sections so you don't waste too much money. We'll start raising and lowering the track too much if you build it in large sections. See like that right there? Can't even talk. See. Been drinking a little bit. Anyways, you can see how high up the track is. It's very, very unnecessary. It's 309,000 to go that far. If you do it the right way, though, let's see, it's 25, 60, which is, what is that, 85. So about 90,000. To go that distance instead of 300,000. So it's very, very important you lay the track correctly. All right, and we're going to stop it right there. Let's go to the other station. And we'll work our way over there. Oops, didn't do that right. There we go, lines connected. Let's go ahead and set up our train depot. Just gonna do it on a fairly level part of the track right in this area. Just wanna make sure I don't block the rail going from the coal mine down here, which we'll do eventually. So let me see where I can put it real fast. I'll probably put it right up here just to make sure it's out of the way. Let's go ahead and set up a train depot right, let's see. I think right there should be about good. Barely let us get it on there, but that's fine. And more importantly, we need to go and buy the train. It's to the general. So on this, you could go with the Baldwin class, but as you see here, the running costs are relatively high. Of course, buying or the purchase price is about double, and so is the running cost. But it goes 37 miles per hour. However, I'm using the lower end passenger cars, not the higher end ones, because of the cost difference. And you can see the top speed of the passenger car is only 31 miles per hour. So buying this that goes 37 miles per hour is completely pointless. Don't waste your money. Buy the general, and then we're going to buy a ton of passenger cars. So let's go ahead and count it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 is a good number. It will fit on the 240 meter track. You could probably go one or two more if you really wanted to. But I say save your money. Let's go ahead and set the line real quick. It's going to go from Monroeville to Pittsburgh Central over here. and back and forth. Next step before we even hit the play and get the time moving is to set up bus terminals in both Monroeville and Pittsburgh Central and Eastern. So let's go ahead and do that first. What I like to do is delete this little piece of road right there. Hit click on the bus icon, set up a large station right here towards Pittsburgh Central and Pittsburgh Eastern. And I'm not sure if we can connect that road or not. Yeah, we can. There we go. And we also need to do a depot. It doesn't really matter per se where you put the depot. Let's see if we can get it in here or not. There we go. And next step is to go ahead and lay out the bus stations. Very, very important you put a bus station down here by the bus terminal so people can basically get delivered here, hop on the train to go to Monroeville. And again, we're just going to work our way around the city here. Probably get one in the center there. And we'll do one or two towards Pittsburgh Central. Should be good. I think that will be plenty right there. Next step is, of course, to buy the vehicles. And we're going to buy the stagecoach for Pittsburgh Central. We could probably get away with the horse carriage and be just fine. Just going to buy 13. We're going to set the line up. Don't have to make this really look that pretty unless you just want it to be for some reason. But just work your way through the stations is all you need to do. I could have done that a lot better, but that's fine. There we go. So the line's set for all those guys. Let's go ahead and do the same thing in Monroeville. I'm not going to build a large station. I'm just going to build a depot. And then some bus stations for this town right here. There we go. Again, very important to put one right by the railroad station. Should be plenty right there. Let me put one more over here somewhere. There we go. Just going to buy some more vehicles right here. We're going to do horse carriages in Monroeville. And again, we'll just buy probably about 10 to 12. Doesn't really make that much of a difference. And we'll go ahead and set the line. Get this off the map so I can see what I'm doing. All right, so again, just work your way through the town right here is fine. There you go. 8 stations right there should be plenty. You can always put one or two more if you really wanted to. It's not a big deal either way. So everything should be set up for this particular line. We still got 500,000 left before even taking the first loan. Let's go ahead and hit play. Make sure that everything starts coming out. That's good. Make sure the train's coming out. Train is coming out. And let's make sure that these guys are coming out as well. Yep, these guys are coming out. So everything is running properly. We can go ahead and 4X it because it's going to take a while for us to start making some money. So while we're doing that, in fact, I'll just play it while we're talking about the metals. There's a couple metals we have to get. Production peak is relatively easy. It's make 8 machines at this factory in a single month. Filled to capacity we'll get fairly quickly, which is transporting at least 70 passengers on the train from station to station. Animal testing we'll go over in a while. Turning point in the warp currents is very hard to get. We have to do it by 1890. We'll go over that in a while. And then coal and coal is going to be our second biggest route, or highest paying route, I should say, other than the passenger line. That's what we're going to set up next. And really, the game wants you to set up all the production over here with the factories and coal mine, iron mine, and the logs right here before doing what I'm about to do. But I found out that this is really a lot easier route to go because it will give you the money you need later on in the mission. So let's go ahead and extend the road out, and we want to do a freight terminal right here. In fact, we want to make it a double track. Make sure to do that as well. We want to point it down as much as possible. And let's go ahead and start running some track real quick. Basically, we're going to be running this to Tesla, so it really has to do... I'm going to take out that loan for $3 million. We've got one more loan we can take out. It's called the Coal with Coal, Inundate Tesla with Coal. So we're basically making a line to the Tesla factory over here, which again, I'll show you here in just a little bit. The most expensive portion of this is basically building the bridge right here. And before we do that, let's go ahead and the Tesla factory is right there. Let's see what they actually call it. Tesla's laboratory is what it actually is. Go ahead and extend this road out just a little bit. We'll make another station, except this one's going to be an endpoint. And make sure that the Tesla laboratory right there lights up so it automatically delivers the coal right there. We don't need a double track, so we'll get rid of that. And there we go, place that, and we'll work our track array around here to our connection point. Let's see if we can do that cheaper than 200 and something thousand, so that's 35, let's say 60. Yeah, so I built that track for 70,000 instead of almost 300,000, so you gotta be really careful when you're laying the track to not waste your money. And more importantly, I do need another train depot. I don't want to use the one below. It doesn't cost a whole lot for one. So let's go ahead and put this over here. And we'll just run the track in here. And let's buy another train. More importantly, again, we're going to go ahead and use the general for this mission. And we need a bunch of gondola cars, which carry coal, iron ore, stone, grain, etc. We're going to be carrying, of course, coal on this one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Take out that last loan. Buy one or two more to make this as efficient as possible. In fact, I'll buy even one more. Let's go ahead and set this line up. Going from Monroe Hat all the way over here to Pittsburgh North Shore West. And that train should be coming out. Again, we spent a lot of money. We may even go negative, but do not worry. There's a reason for everything. We can go ahead and go into 4X. So the zero passengers on there, it's gonna take a while for us to stop or start making money on the passenger line. It just takes a while for the stations to fill up and get more busy. Same with this coal train. So basically, I didn't pick up any coal initially. You can see zero of 77 right there. We're actually going to turn this guy around here shortly. Otherwise, it's going to go all the way over to Tesla without anything and just waste money. And it costs a lot of money to run these trains. And so you don't really want to run them empty if you don't have to. And you can see the coal is automatically building up on the platform there. And we'll turn this around. Let's go ahead and turn it around now. It's going to make one basically fairly empty run all the way over there before it starts picking up full loads of coal, which is, again, not a big deal. Next step is we're going to have to start working on all these resources, getting them over here along with transferring some coal down to the steel factory. So that will be our goal here shortly. Let's look at how many people are on the train real quick. 43. So again, not going to make a whole lot of money on that. And we're not going to get the fill to capacity metal quite yet. But don't worry, it is coming, guys. Anyways, I'll go ahead and set this up while we still have some money. And we're just going to put a road depot up here by the lumber yard. And we're also going to put a truck station, or freight station is what I really want to call it. And for that freight station, we got to actually deliver it down here. Oops, clicking on the wrong one. Just put a bus station down here by the sawmill. And also, here's a little cheat I like to do. Cut the distance and by a little bit right there. It costs a lot of money to do it, but it's going to save a lot of time from these trucks having to go all the way up here and back down. They're just going to cut across right there. So on this, basically, we have to produce 10 machines. It's very important to do this as quick as possible, because the next step after producing 10 machines really has to do with the turning point in the War of Currents, which is convincing all districts of the benefits of alternating current by the year 1890. You can see we're already 1881. So time is of the essence. However, we probably have plenty of time to do everything. I wouldn't worry about it too much. And don't have any metals quite yet. We should get a metal on this. Nope, still not going to get the metal on this one quite yet. So probably when this train comes back from Pittsburgh, it should have more than 70 people on it, because you can already see all these people lining up. Yeah, there's already almost 100 people at the platform. So I'm going to hold off on doing anything. Well, it's got 400,000, so I can go ahead and do a couple more things. I'm not going to buy any trucks yet. I'm just going to start running the stations and the tracks for the next step. So let's go ahead and do that. So we have to bring iron ore down to the steel mill, and then these wood planks down here as well. And the wood planks have to be transferred over to the machine factory, which we'll talk about that here in a little bit. So again, go to the train symbol, click on freight. We're going to do an end station for this one right here. And the next step can be kind of difficult if you don't do it properly. I'm going to try to do it the first time. That's not working out for me. Let's try this. I guess I should have ran the road first before putting the bus station. And I've never run it around this way either. I've always run it up. So let me delete the bus station real quick. It doesn't cost a whole lot of money. And then we run... Oh, it's still going the wrong way. How about this? I don't remember having that much difficulty ever with that, but that's fine. Just a tad bit more if I can. And then we'll build a pass-through freight station real fast if we have enough money. If not, we'll hold off. Nope, I'm running out of money already, so not a problem. Let's go into 4X until we make some money. Again, once this train goes to the coal station, or coal mine, I should say, and back to Tesla, will make quite a bit of money. And we're still not making money with the passenger train quite yet. Do not click on that, is unfortunate. We know the money is depleted. Don't worry about that. We have positive cash flow route set up, so it's not the end of the mission. And this will be a, well, not a full train, but over 100 people, which is good. Not going to build anything. I'm just going to hold off because we've got a lot of train expenses going back and forth. So we'll just follow this train all the way over. That's what we're going to do. Probably should have left it in 4X while I was doing some of those things on the material route or freight route, but it's not a big deal. Pretty massive passenger train, in my opinion, though, which is good. Massive train equals massive money. Down the road, we got a massive coal train as well, which is going to be really, really big. That will probably pay close to $800,000 once it delivers, and this should pay around $800,000 as well when it's completely full of passengers. I am curious to see exactly what that coal train pays initially. We can always upgrade it and add more gondolas if we need to for any reason as well. We'll go ahead and slow down time once we make some money here. There we go. Got filled to capacity metal right there. 1 of 5 down. Let's see how much we make with this guy right here. There you go, 600,000. And let's go ahead and speed it up. I'm not going to spend any money until we get some money from this train. Hopefully it's full. Pretty close, 69 to 77 coal, so it'll be full next time around, which is good. This should hopefully pay maybe 800,000 if we're lucky. Get us to over the million mark, or just under it. And you'll see that this is lit up right here by the station. It will automatically deliver the coal over to Tesla, and you'll see it line up here in just a second. So I paid 860,000, which is good. Let's go ahead and slow time down to a pause real quick as I work on setting up all of this. In fact, we can hit play. It's not going to be that big of a deal. Hopefully we can connect these two stations. We can, which is good. Again, try to work in small sections if you can at all, just to save money. And before we do that, let's go ahead and set up this side before we go across the track there. Set up another freight station here, and I want two tracks on this one. It's very important. We can make this an end station as well. Okay, so we really got to swing that around if we can. Go. It's going to go into 4x because we're about to go in the negative yet again. And how many people do we have on the train? 98. That's not too bad. Usually my cities are doing a little bit better as far as the amount of passengers on the tracks. I'm not sure why they're not doing as good. Might need to buy a couple more stagecoaches, or maybe I didn't set up the route quite as well as I have on some other missions or scenarios, but we should be fine either way. Let's see how many people are here. 112. Still a decent payday. Should be 600,000-700,000, hopefully. That was 500 right there. Alright, so once these two both deliver, we'll have hopefully enough money to complete this line and buy at least one of the trains that we need. And we'll go over that here in a little bit as well. This train should be pretty close to 425 passengers, which is good. Another 125 waiting on the other side, so things are going good on that. And the coal train's getting pretty close to delivery as well. There we go, 644,000, not bad. Go, and first and foremost, we'll set up this route here in just a second. We don't have enough money to do it quite yet, but we're getting really close. So let's go ahead and put it in a depot. Set that up. We can get on the track there. There we go, that's good enough. Go ahead and go in the 4X. So pretty close to being set up on this entire route. We got a couple things we have to do, which we'll go over here in a second and hopefully explain it. There we go. Got almost a million from that delivery. So that's awesome. We can go ahead and buy a train with that, hopefully. And we'll buy one, two gondolas. So yeah, we still need quite a bit more money to buy the train. So we're going to have to wait a little bit before we do that. I'm going to turn off the contour lines. We don't really need it right now. So the coal train's basically giving us a million each trip. And the passenger train that we have running right now is giving us anywhere from 600,000 to 800,000 so far. We're already in 1883, so we need to start getting the machines produced as soon as possible is our next step. Go 700,000 right there. I guess we could go ahead and run the train. I don't know if we should or not. I really want to upgrade it more before we run the train, so I'll wait. I'm gonna wait till the coal train goes back, makes another run, and the passenger train makes another run as well. Good news, though, is, oh, I was going to say the passenger train's full, but it's not, so much for that one. I probably need to get, again, a couple more stagecoaches going to transport more passengers around Pittsburgh Central and Pittsburgh Eastern. Definitely need to get this train moving as quickly as possible, though. And what I'll probably do initially is combine this track if I can. Let me see if I can even do that. Well, I don't have money to even try it. Okay, so the passengers will hit first, which is good. This will be almost a full train going back to Pittsburgh, which is good as well. You can see our negatives, 414,000. Not doing as good as I would like to do. I've done a little bit better in the past, but I'm not doing bad by any means either. I got us out of debt right there, and the money train is almost on its way. I'm just going to buy one more gondola, one more state car, and then run the line real quick, along with doing a couple other things I'll show you here in a minute. So let's go ahead and set the line real fast. New line. It's going to stop at iron ore. mine, the log, or sawmill, I guess I should say, to pick up logs, and then stop down here as well. So that's off and running. Next step is to transport the lumber from the forest down to the sawmill to make the logs. So let's go ahead and set that up. And we're going to buy horse carts. I can always buy more down the road. This will be the pink line. Oh, I need to set up a passenger area right there. So we go back to add a station. There we go. So those guys are all set up. You can see all the wood stacked up right here. That will slowly go over there. Let's go back to 4X mode. The only thing that we're missing is transporting coal, which I'm going to stop it. I'm actually going to use the train that we're using for Tesla to transport coal down there as well initially until I can buy another train. Go. Let me look at this train real quick. Hopefully it doesn't mess up my cash flow too much. And we need a change line for it. So it's going North Shore. Move. So let's go ahead and add a station. So it got rid of the coal initially. That's going to really hurt us. But it's for the best. Three. And four. There we go. And hopefully by the time the train gets there, it'll be enough coal to bring down here to start making steel. And once we get enough money, we need to start another truck route down here, which I'll go over here in a minute. This guy probably has nothing on it. We probably need to turn it around. Yep, let's go ahead and turn this guy around. Passenger train should hopefully give us 200,000-300,000 to work with. There we go. Let's go ahead and set up another line real quick. So click on the bus. We're going to make a bus stop down here. And we're going to make a truck station up here. Basically, when it makes steel, the steel will go here. And we're going to transport the steel and also the logs down to the machines. The logs will actually be delivered to the station directly though. And we need another depot. So set up the depot. Go ahead and buy some horse carts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's buy two more. Set line. There you go. And we'll be off and running on producing machines. It's going to take a long time for the production to ramp up to the point where we can do it. All right, we'll finally be getting some iron ore delivered at least. I don't know why he's going down there. Let me look at line 5, make sure it's correct. Come on back, train. I want you to go back to Southern. I don't want you to go back to that place. Oh, I guess we'll just let the train run its course. This will all stack up. Not a big deal anyways. We have the... Oh, speaking of that, I can't even get this train to come down here until I set up the signals, which... That's not good. I'm actually going to stop this train, turn it around, and redo the line just to get it to go to the right place because we're definitely running out of money now. So let's go ahead and do this again, add the stations up, And it's going to go down here. There we go. And we'll unstop it. Ugh, completely forgot to set up the signals there, so now the train is stuck until this gets into the station. At least I'm going to be making enough money to go ahead and correct that issue. Almost a full train right there. Alright, let's go ahead and correct this before we mess this up. I haven't really quite figured out the signals exactly. I probably don't need that many on there, but this will prevent most issues. All right, we should actually have some stuff on this train, hopefully. 5 planks, yay. That's all we have. Oh well. What can you do? And when is our coal trains right here? I was like, when are we gonna be making a lot of money from the coal train? But we're not. Getting a little bit nervous. It's not going as good as I thought it would go this time around, but I think we're still gonna be okay. Regardless, we'll see how this goes. I got the line set up. It's just a matter of getting the coal train back all the way over to Tesla and eventually buying a separate coal train to run from the coal mine just down here by itself is what we really need. All right. This will hopefully pay for some of the bills right here. And it's gonna be a full train too. We got, or pretty close to full train, about 150 people. That one had 122 on it, which is good. And we got a lot of coal to pick up to head over to Tesla, so that'll be about $1 million payday. Let's see how this line's doing. Have we got anything? Good, we got planks and we got iron ore going down, which is a huge plus. We'll be able to make just a little bit of steel because there's not much coal here, but the little bit of steel that we do have along with the wood or the logs will actually go over here to start making machines. Let's see, hopefully this guy's full. Yep, 77 of 77, which is good. That guy's full as well. So my hope is to build a separate train for the coal going back and forth over here. Now this guy's starting to make money, which is good. That'll help pay some of the bills. And you can see the logs automatically go right here to be picked up. And there's steel right there as well. And with both of those items, we'll be able to make machines, and eventually we'll have to transport the machines up here to the industrial section, which again, I'll go over that in a little bit as well. All right, 564, not exactly enough to buy a train quite yet, but once this delivers the coal, we should hopefully be able to. Maybe just buy a cheap train with 3 to 4 carts if we need to. All right, let's see how this goes. Let's try to buy a separate train. And we're gonna do the Baldwin 6-wheel, the cheapest possible, because the gondolas are fairly expensive. 2, 3, 4, 5. Good, it got us 5, which is good. Set line. And before we run out of money, we do put that on pause. I need to make a couple of adjustments here. Okay. In fact, I need to change this train real quick. Change line 4. That, and we're going to remove that as well. There we go. That train set up. And let me put in... Oh, I don't have the money to put in the signal. I should have kept it paused. Let's go ahead and speed it up. So that's going to be a waste of a coal train for a little bit until we get a little bit of money. Oh man, I messed that up. Should have kept it in pause. Hopefully, that's not going to bring us above the 230 that we owe right now, but the passenger train will. Still only have one metal. We're already at 1886, and we're getting pretty close to 1890. Only 4 years to go. And there's a really important part to get in that metal, which is coming up, and I'll show you guys that here in a little bit. There we go, got 600,000. And in fact, with that, I'm actually going to do a couple of things. Get rid of this track, we don't need that. And let's get rid of that. Keep these from ever crossing, period. Train should be coming out now, which is good. A couple more of these for these guys. And so the next step, since I have a little bit of money, I'm gonna go ahead and put it in play. This probably has nothing on it quite yet. So let me look at it. It does have a little bit of coal. We'll have it go ahead and go then. So very important part of the turning point in War of the Currents metal right here. You have to transport people on the tram. That's really the only thing. And we're already getting close to the time limit at 1890. We're producing machines, which will pop the 3 missions for the turning point in the War of the Currents. But I want to go ahead and start this as soon as possible. Get this out of the way. So we need to build a tram depot right here. And then we got to build a couple bus stations. Or tram stations, I should say. Excuse me. Not going to build a whole lot right now. I'm going to make it relatively simple because you have to upgrade the street. So click on the street, click on this little icon right here, and we have to electrify the streets, which costs quite a bit of money. Should be everything should be electrified between those stations, and I need to buy a couple of trams. I can only buy one right now, but at least I can go ahead and set the lineup for future ones. There you go, that's good right there. You can already see the trams leaving the station. And the next thing we do when we get money is to actually buy a few more of those trams. That's very important. All right, we'll finally have some coal to be making steel. We may upgrade that tram. May upgrade this train as well here in a minute. Let me go back over here because that passenger train's about to deliver. We need to buy some more trams. Yeah, going to set the line. And our good old money-making coal train should be hitting right about now. I should have just let that thing go and by itself instead of messing up the route. Neither here or there now. Not a big deal. I think what I'm going to do, though, is upgrade this coal train real quick. Since I have the money to do it. Go ahead and go back to the general. Right there. We're going to add a couple more gondolas to it. Be nice if I could see the line. Make sure. Set it to the correct one. There we go. New coal train coming out. It might be a little bit of an overkill as far as this train goes, but it's not a big deal. Let's see how the passengers are doing. Okay, so now we have to convince the districts before 1890. Very important we go ahead and do this. Let's hit it in slower mode. Click on the question mark right here. This is slander one. You're gonna come down to, let's see where the next question mark is. There's one right there. Again, this is, you have to transport basically 100 people by streetcar. That's why I went ahead and set up that line right there. We should hopefully easily get that before 1890. And then we have this over here, which is deliver coal to Nikola Tesla, which we already have the line set up for that. There is the second part of the slander. The third part's right here. And all you have to do is bulldoze this guy right here. Oh, I don't have money to bulldoze it, so I have to give it a second. Let's go ahead and speed up the game real quick. I don't see my coal train for some reason. Oh, there it is. It's like, where'd it go? Does this guy have any coal on it? Only 19. So yeah, that train was definitely overkill, but neither here or there now. All right, let me hit play. Go ahead and get rid of this house right here. It gives us the animal testing medal. Prevent Dr. Brown from performing his brutal practices. So again, that's a pretty easy medal to get. The hardest medal to get is the coal and the transport people by electric streetcar, which we're already working on. Wouldn't worry too much about that. We should be set up with just the few stations that we do have. I'm gonna add a few more of these carts. Go. Fairly full passenger train, and our coal train is coming around as well. Only train I really need to upgrade is going to be this one, and in fact, I should probably go ahead and send it to the depot before it picks anything up. Add a couple more gondolas and lumber carts on there. I should be getting some money from the coal transport to Tesla. There we go. Got 1 million. Let's go ahead and add a couple gondolas. There we go. Set the line again. I don't know why I didn't go to the iron factory first, but we'll just let it run its course, go back there here in a minute. See, you already got 77 coal delivered to Tesla, already transported 20 people. The only thing I might do would be to buy a couple more trams if we get some more money. Just to ensure that we actually do transport 100 people by 1890, I think we'll be fine, but you never know. It's actually not that big of a deal that this one didn't have the iron ore on there, because you can see we have plenty of iron ore. We really need the coal train to get down here as soon as possible. Which this one hopefully should be full. Nope, it's only about half full. Alright, let me go ahead and buy some more tram cars. Set the line to line 9. And I might go ahead and add in a bus stop as well. Bus stop or two, I should say. First and foremost, we may actually want to, on this one, let's go ahead and vehicles age as a result of the damage. I would like to pay them off. I need money to do that, though, is the problem. Let me wait till I get the money and I'll just pay them off. I think we should be good on the transport people by electric streetcar, so I'm gonna let that go. Once I get time to do it, I should say. It's a full train, so that's definitely gonna pay quite a bit. And then the coal will pay quite a bit as well. There we go. Ended the strike right there. And we're going to be good on the transport of people, so I'm not going to add in those bus stations like I could have. There we go. Delivered coal to Nikola Tesla is completed. We got the inundate Tesla with coal already. So now we just need the... Oh, there we go. Production peak. We got that. And we got coal with coal. So really it's just transporting people... by the streetcar is really what we need next. It's making me a little nervous. I'm going to slow it down. Then I'm going to add in these two lines just in case. Again, I don't think I have to do this, but you never know. Again, maybe it can make the line a little bit better by doing that. So let me click on one of the trams, click on line 9. Yeah, I really hate to mess with this line. It's the only issue. That's fine. Let me go ahead and add a couple more tramps just in case. There we go. We should be good. We're almost at 100 already. Oh, what's giving us a problem? Okay, so we need to ship more items outside the factory. This is pretty easy to do, and this is the only thing I really haven't set up. So right here, we're going to set up a... Oops, clicked on the wrong one. Actually, we don't need to... Let's do a small truck station or freight station, and then we'll put a bus stop down there. And we need to just put it in the industrial area, which if you look at here, anywhere in this yellow area is fine. Of course, up here would be best, pay probably a little bit more, but it's not a big deal. And we just need to buy a couple road vehicles. And we're just going to run it from right here up to the industrial section. And what that's going to do is when this factory makes machines, the machines will go on this platform. The machines will actually get transferred and sold to the industrial section, which greatly increases that city. All right, so that should hopefully go away here in just a second. Did I set up the line? I should have. Yeah, so it's working. It's going to take a second for that to stop flashing more than likely. So the only thing we're missing is by 1890, and we should get that here in just a second. Transported 91 people. I should have set up the tram line a little bit sooner, but I wasn't doing as good on money as I have in the past. But they're definitely running. Got plenty of trams out there. I guess it doesn't hurt to add a couple more. 96 people, we're in July, we're in August. There we go, we got it. There it is. So now we just need to produce 100 machines, which should be more than easy. We got all of the gold medals right there. The line's entirely set up. We don't have to change anything whatsoever. And we're gonna have plenty of money raking in. So you can see the machines loading up right here from the factory, and the production of the factory will slowly go up to... Let me add a couple more vehicles. There we go, just to make sure those machines get off the platform as soon as possible. Let's see how this coal train's doing. Almost full. Got a good supply of coal and iron ore right there to make the steel. Plenty of shipments going out. Looks like almost every cart is fairly full for the most part. Now the money's just basically gonna roll in like crazy. I'll probably end up with at least 4 million before the 100 machines are produced. And you could do some more expansion. I could make a second passenger train. I could do all sorts of things right now. There's really no need to. Hopefully this was helpful. If you guys haven't already, please hit the subscribe button below. Also follow me at twitch.tv/middleagedgamer. I'm hoping this video was very helpful. If you have any questions on anything, or how something works, or if something doesn't make sense on the video, just leave a comment below. I do reply to all comments on YouTube as well, and I'll definitely get back to you. It takes a day or two for me to get back to you, so don't worry. I will be willing to help you out with this game as much as possible, along with doing future missions as well. Oh, look at that. We got plenty. Oh, I need to add more trucks with lumber. I got plenty of iron ore. Not enough trucks moving down here. I should have caught that a little bit earlier. Way too much lumber to move, and the production is really low on the sawmill, so... It's those little things that can hurt you if you don't pay attention. I definitely did not pay attention on that. We're not running full coal loads with this train, simply because there's not enough iron ore. And this is the iron ore train. Probably could add a couple more gondolas on that to fix that problem, but not really needed at this point. See, it's full of coal right there. We'll finally get some iron ore on that. Plenty of steel and logs going to the factory to make machines. Plenty of machines coming out to go get sold. There you go. You can see the passenger lines, one of the top grossing lines right there. You can see how old the trains and trucks are as well. Sixty-five machines produced so far. Really, really good graphics. I mean, when you zoom in, the level of detail, you can see passengers in the cart right there, which is pretty neat in my opinion. See the track signals are working right there, which is good. Already at 2.3 million. So again, you could definitely, from this point in the mission, you could expand like crazy, of course. I doubt the mission's going to be that easy. There's a reason why you have to do things within a certain time frame. That's what makes it difficult. There we go. So looks like we're running low on steel, and we're not making enough steel because we don't have enough gondolas. I could upgrade that for the fun of it, but by the time I do that, we'll already have 100 machines produced, so it's not really a big deal. Weird thing is the passenger side did not do as well. I think it's how I set up my stations. I didn't do as good of a job as I should have. Probably should have done maybe one or two less stations and cleaned up the route a little bit. Not a huge deal, but made the starting a little bit more difficult than it had to be. Got two coal trains coming in. There we go. That's it. So that's the industrialization mission of the America campaign on Transport Fever. That's how you get all 5 gold medals right there. And I'll take a screenshot of that so I can use it for the YouTube video thumbnail. Anyways, thank you for watching the Middle Age Gamer. Definitely appreciate all of you guys out there for watching. Make sure to like the video, comment below, and of course subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys on the next video. Cheers.